Hey guys, welcome back to Flatpak Effects, and in today's tutorial we're going to be making this. So stick around, you're watching Flatpak Effects. Welcome back to the tutorial, guys. Now jumping straight into this one, I thought I'd show you an easy way to make the Star Wars opening title sequence where we have the horizontal text sort of moving off into the distance. Now before we get started, you're going to want to download this file here, which is this Star's Milky Way image, and I've put that in a link in the description below. And next, we're just gonna right click and create a new composition. I'm gonna call this one Star Wars Text. And I'm going to set this one to be 1080x25 and give yourself at least 10 seconds duration there, then hit OK. Next, we're going to create another composition, but for this one, I want to set my width to be 1920, but my height, I'm going to change this to be 4,500. So we should have this as square pixels, 1920, 4,500, and our duration to be the same as our Star Wars text composition, and hit OK. Now this is going to give us quite a long, skinny composition here. And what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to hit this little button here just to turn off the background layer. Next, I'm going to come up here to my type tool, and I simply just want to draw a box so it sits roughly on the inside of that layer or our composition here. Next, you can just manually type out your text, or you can paste in the text that you actually want to use. So in my case, I just went online and just found the actual text that I wanted to use from the opening sequence. And I just simply copied that and pasted it into this composition. Okay, so the first thing we notice is it only fills a very small portion of our box, and we want it to fill our entire box. So because we've already set the boundaries of our text box, if I select all, I can simply just scale this up, and you'll notice straight away that it's filled more of our box. Now for me, I've set this to be about 131, which is my text size here. And what I'm also going to do is change this to be Arial font. Now the next issue we actually notice here is that it's all left justified, and we want it to actually fill across to the other side here. So we do this by just going to our paragraph tab on the right hand side here. Now if your paragraph tab isn't there, you can come up to window and just make sure paragraph is selected, and you'll notice these buttons over here. So these are your justification for your text, and the one we actually want to use are these ones here. So you'll notice as I move these, as I click these, it's actually changing the layout of our text. Now, the one I actually want to use here is this one here. So it justifies my text from left to right, but it also keeps it on the left-hand side if it doesn't quite have enough to fill. So that's the effect that we actually get, and that's what we're going for. The other thing we can do is I can change my text color to match more the Star Wars sort of yellow. So something like that. And if you've got a few gaps in between some of these words, you can simply just mess around with your text just to help fill in a few of those gaps. So that'll depend on the text you actually want to put in there, but you can adjust the size. You can mess around with the settings just to fill those gaps till you get a result you're happy with. Now, the other thing I've done here is I've also just typed out a title. So I've called mine Episode 1. If I select just that text layer, I can hit this button and that's going to center justify it. And you can also adjust the size individually of that. But on my next line down, I'm just going to type out my title and just make this slightly larger here till I end up with something that looks like this. Now, doing it this way is a lot easier because you don't have to mess around with changing the text in a three-dimensional space. I can simply just edit this like I would a Word document, and then I'm actually going to animate this composition in a separate composition just to make it easier to tie this whole effect together. So once you're happy with your text here, I'm going to go back to my Star Wars text layer, and I'm going to drag that composition from my project window on top. Now at the moment, this composition is going to be a completely different size from that composition that we've been editing our text in. Now I'm also going to drag in my star map underneath and scale it up just so we can see what we're doing here. And the next part of this, we actually want to rotate it so it's sitting more horizontal. So we do this by selecting our composition, and I'm going to make this a 3D layer. And just so it's more precise, I'm going to go down to the transform properties, and I'm going to change the X rotation, the second number, to be negative 75. And that's going to rotate it so that it sits on the correct orientation. Now, the other thing I'm going to do is select my layer, and you'll notice this box here, which is actually the edges of this of our text composition. We want these little boxes to be sitting on this bottom corner here or close to it. So I select that composition, and you'll notice this little Y, X, and Z axis have appeared. I need to grab the blue one, which is the Z axis, and I'm simply just going to drag this down so that it sits closer to the bottom there. So that's what we end up with here. Now, the other thing I'm going to do is I'm going to drag my playhead back to zero. I'm going to set a position keyframe, and I'm going to zoom in on the timeline here and go to roughly 10 seconds and create another keyframe. And for this one, we're going to select our green arrow here, which is our Y axis. And if I click this, and if I hold shift at the same time, I can shift it off into the distance. So I'm going to shift it roughly about there for our end keyframe. And for our beginning keyframe, I'm just going to move it so it appears off frame or starts from out of frame. Now, if I played that, you can see we've already got that text sort of animation happening as it does in the film. Now, at the moment, it is a little bit fast, and I can adjust that time by simply dragging this out. So if I want to halve the speed, I can drag it out to 20 seconds. So this will depend on how much text you actually have in there. It will depend on how quickly you want it to flow out, or just so people can read the text that's actually on there. So you can adjust your time depending on what text you've put in there. Okay, so once you've done that, the other thing you'll notice is in the film, the text sort of disappears or fades off as it goes into the distance. Now, at the moment, ours just stays solid. So we need to create a mask across the background so that it disappears as it moves further away from the camera. Now, we do this by creating a mask over our layer and animating that mask. I'm going to go back to zero here with the playhead. I'm going to select my composition. I'm going to come up to the pen tool or hit G on the keyboard. And I simply just want to create a mask that sits roughly a quarter way down the screen from the top and fills quite wide out, so it's not close to these bottom edges here. And you'll see why in a minute. Now, next, I'm going to create a mask path keyframe for that mask. And I'm going to move across towards the end of our composition. And I simply just want to click so that it goes from boxes to little circles. And I'm going to move the edges of my mask roughly back down to where we first drew them. So I need this top line here to be about a quarter way down from the top. And I want these lines down here to be well away from this edge. Now, you'll notice as it's moving along, the text now disappears through that mask. Now, the next part of this is all we need to do is create a mask feather. So I can simply just drag this up to about 1,000 pixels here. And what you'll notice is this gives it a bit more of a feathered edge. Now, you can increase this to increase that feather to something like that, just to give it a bit more of a feather sort of drop off there. So it looks like it's fading away in the distance. And that's pretty much it. So if I play through what we have here now, this is what we should have. Now, if you liked this tutorial, don't forget to like and subscribe. And I've also made this project file available for free download in the description below. So thanks very much for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next tutorial. And remember, Flatpak Effects is the Flatpak anyone can build.